worked. It's recording. Welcome, bee friends.
Yes, yes it is.
Welcome, bee friends.
Out of the way, Rose. Okay, suit up time.
Go and play some bees. Hey. Oh, almost got my suit done. Hey, what's going on here? Woo! Almost. Oh, that'll work.
Depth perception.
Are you smoking over there?
That doesn't sound good.
Going, Smokey? Hey, that's a fire, that's not smoke. That's better. Morning, girls. Oh, nicely propolized.
Yeah, careful, that wind is a bit iffy.
Hello, ladies. How you going? It's been nicely propolized. Hey, girls. How we going? Oh, you're smoking. Doing so well.
I need a dead bee on the wing board.
Yeah, that'll happen. Why is it wherever I stand, you puff smoke at me? It's all sticky. Hi, ladies.
Yeah, one of the middle frames was absolutely chockers full. We could have actually harvested if we wanted to, but we showed that to the
It's not quite full of the spring yet, so.
Yeah, Rose. Hey, you want to bring my camera and put it over there in the shade? Don't drop it. Oh, then again, it is you, not me. How's the screen look? Don't put it in the sun. Move back a bit. Now, can you see the screen? Does it look alright, or you got parts of it, or? A little to the right. A little to the right.
Okay, now you move that way. Perfect. And you can also see the box.
Oh, and you can also see the box. Fantastic. What do I do with this now?
You sure?
You know this is going to fall over because there's no weight on top of it?
Well, you ain't got to put a couple frames on there.
Are you sure? I don't think any of them are ready to harvest.
No.
By looking at the back of them.
No.
I don't think you need to pull all them out. We'll just have a look at a couple of them.
There's some of these.
Yeah, a bit of nectar and a little bit of cap honey at the top. You're getting close to capping that one off.
Yeah, I think it's this one here.
Mm-hmm.
It's it was very, very full and capped.
Yeah, no, they've eaten all that. I don't think we need to go through much more of this one.
No, I don't think so, because it's more interesting what's happening in the brood side of it.
Mm.
To see whether it's going to be
Definitely.
A swarming issue or not.
Yeah, it's the end frames.
Mm.
They've got a bit of weight in them. You seem to be good at playing with smoke. Come on, ladies, out of the way, please. Yes, I'm not really here to hurt you. I'm here to keep you, your bees. Sure, this will be mostly honey. Was last time we looked at it, it was all honey. No brood. We had a lot of frames in the brood box that had a fair bit of brood in it. Yeah. You could nearly harvest that one if you wanted to, but you don't have a thing to harvest it with. I don't know if we've got any spare frames to pull it out.
Have you got any of these ones or not? Will not leave you any?
I might have. I'll look in the shed.
If you want to have a look, because we could almost take maybe that one off because it's full. You could just cut it out if you wanted to and have a honeycomb. Depending on what you want to do. Because if you've got a couple, it would probably free up some space in here for them. Honey, 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 honey.
Yeah, I've got one, but he's got no
wax. Well, one's better than none.
Doesn't have the
That's alright, they'll work it out.
That's let's see how one of these I've got.
That's a shame, I thought I left them. Oh, there's brood in this one. Cool.
Oh, we got brood on that side. Cat brood. It's pretty cool. And there's some uncapped brood too. Oh, I wonder if the queen's on here. Never thought of that. Whoops. Better put you back over the top of the box so I don't lose her in case she's here.
Oh, I didn't think of that. That's silly. Very, very silly. You here, Queenie? There's a drone. I don't see her. Pretty cool. here too. Cool. Brood on both sides.
Here you go, cameras. There's a drone cell there in the middle at the bottom poking out. It's in here. It's in here, it's a drone cell. Bullet shaped one. There's a few drones on there. Running around. Same on the other side. Definitely a nice strong side. Okay. Investigation continues. Excuse me, ladies. No, not a queen cell, it's just the start of one. Nothing in it. Oops, I broke open some larvae, but it looks like it's a drone cell, so it should be alright. They're working on a queen cell here on the bottom, but there's nothing in it. See this round one here? Get it on these other cameras. So, there's a queen cell there. I'll just have a look inside. But there's nothing in it, it's just a practice cell. Probably get rid of that. Well, it doesn't hurt them to have it. Oh, hello. Yes, I know.
So, yeah, you got brood in the top, and you've got a queen cell on this one, but it's a practice cell. I have four frames. Four of those. Okay. Have you got any normal frames? By the way. Yeah. You may need them if you get down to the bottom and it's honey bound.
The only thing is, they don't have any starters on them.
Starter strips?
Yeah. We got some paddle pop sticks, but they don't stay in there.
They're all clear.
Yeah, we can't really glue them down.
Probably not.
Maybe get a tripod on there or something and wedge it in there.
Four babies, no pollen.
Side, but there's a few. Cap, yeah, those cap brood, those yellow ones. Oh yeah, down here.
Yeah, they're all the cap babies. And on this side. And there's pollen there in the middle. And there's one there with a hole. It looks like it's trying to come out. That's honey.
Yeah, where that clear one is.
It's still honey. Yep. See over here in the middle. There's one that's just coming out. There's a bee emerging. If you can see it, bee just walked over it. In the middle of the hive. Yep, just walk over it again. She's coming out. Cell's just starting to open. She's chewing her way out. I see her little antennas are sticking out every now and there. Yeah.
through.
Where's your camera, Jeff? Where's your camera?
Got a bee in the middle of the frame here, trying to get out. I just moved some of the wax capping.
Little
hatching. I'll see if I can hold it. Just here. The end of my tool is. There's a bee coming out. If you want, I'll hand this to you and you can hold it. You see? There it is. It's coming out of there.
Want me to do a check? You're videoing?
You're standing in front of my camera.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
That's alright.
You're videoing?
Yeah.
Okay, where is she
now? I can't see now because there's got bees everywhere. Just there on the frame. Yeah. She's coming
out. Where are you going, Jeffrey?
Just wait for those bees to move. Just coming out of that hole. It's the big black thing on the frame.
Let me. I can't see it.
I'll give you this.
Yeah.
You and Mum go over there in the shade. Like that. Go that way. Brood in here. My dog's being naughty over there. Cap cells there. Oh, that's a drone. It's noisy. More cap cells in front of my camera. Yeah, if I turn around, see if I can get behind the camera and have a look. Got cap cells there. This is just a small one. I haven't even got into the big part of the hive yet.
Good thing, huh?
Oh, yeah. This thing's rocketing away. You're going to have to do a split.
Yeah, well, that's why I've got the other hybrid to go.
Yep.
Well, if we have to, we can probably do it today if you want to.
This one's a bit wonky looking. This is mostly honey and pollen. It's a bit wonky. This one's all wonky. It's on the outside. It's got honey and pollen.
Oh,
I don't know. Do you want to keep it and harvest it? It's up to you. Okay, what are you doing? Oh, are you? That's
alright. But she's still trying to chew it
up. Oh, okay. Where is she? Oh, yeah, just there. That's alright. My little one. There you go, look. There she is. She's coming out. Right here, the little tiny furry one. Mm-hmm. Oh, there she is. She's out.
She's
here.
I can see
her. Oh, there. That's her. Little furry one.
put her back in there so that she's with the bees, that way if anything happens.
So I've got four little frames, and I've got four big ones.
Yep. Alright, what we'll do,
if you think we should do them today, we can.
Well, I'm going to say, if we put a couple of these in and take those two honey ones out, the base and the bottom box, you don't need the top one.
No. And that's pretty much ready. I mean, it's only painted this morning, but I see maybe a bit of propolis in there somewhere.
Sort of. What's that for?
For the things to keep them wedged in.
Well, what you do is you offset them like this and jam them in together. Some of your Brockless girls.
So you want me to go down and get the base and
come on girls, move. If you want to go get it, you need the base.
Yeah, the base and the bottom
the
box.
The base and bottom box, and you need the lid and the inner cover.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We'll be back.
Okay, you do that. I'll start putting this all back in. Oops, sorry, girls. I didn't upset you. That's not the same as the other one I did. Some of these are wider than the others. That doesn't really help me. Take some of your props, girls. I'm sorry.
great. There's so much propolis, I can use it to stick on the stick, so I can stick the stick into the channel, so we can put it all in here, so the bees can then use it for something to construct their comb off. Cool. I'll come over here. So what I've done, put in paddle pop sticks, and I've got some of the propolis from the bees, and I've just pushed it in against this to hold all the sticks in on both sides, and the bees can use that as a starting strip. So it's a little bit different, but it'll work. The other one I did the same, but the groove in here was wider, so I actually put two paddle pop sticks and I put them offset, so they all held in there together. So that'll do for a strip. Now, this is going to get a little bit dicey. I'm going to end up with bees everywhere in a second. So if you're not wearing protective gear, I wouldn't be here. Get it? Bee here?
It's being hilarious. It's only a D-grade joke.
Yeah, very much so. Come on, little ones.
Well, the leapers. Gonna make it interesting.
Ooh, sounds like somebody brought another beehive with them.
The only thing is I haven't set up the angles and
everything
yet.
Well, I'll start on that. I'll still gotta get into this yet. They're getting grumpy now, so I need to start doing those things. Grab the little piece with the holes for the vents in it on the veranda at the back of this.
Problems?
No. I need you to hurry up so I can work out what I'm doing. Yeah, that's out.
And I'm just bringing the back bit to make sure I got it.
Where's your pointer?
Level. Only because we've got them open so long and you're taking so long. I'll calm down in a minute. So I've got it very close to the middle of that one.
Okay.
And it's very, very close across the top, so. That's full of pollen. Take some of those frames out as soon as you can. Trickle them out. This in here because that's got pollen on it. In the light, everything's here. Pollen and cat brood. Put that one in. Well, it won't matter where the queen goes, I suppose. Because
no, she'll be in one or the other, and the other one will build the
make her own queen. Yeah.
I want to see eggs or very, very young larvae, or milk brood as they call it. Tons of drones. Cat brood. That's... Oh, careful! Yep, I've just seen that. Yeah, I see that. Very old comb.
That's one of our frames, it's not one of his.
No.
Only one of his left in there now.
Yeah. I think there's some eggs in there, but I can't really tell. I didn't get a good enough look and it started moving on me. Yeah, just to see if you can see eggs. It's going to be a hard part. But seeing as it's a dark comb, little tiny grains of rice in the bottom. If you're lucky. If not, we can move them over, and if they don't have one, we can just put more larvae over next time wherever the queen happens to be, and she'll put them in there.
Stuff.
All right. Well, I'll put it in anyway. So we got three frames so far. So there's brood and pollen. She'll be here somewhere. There's a drone that didn't make it. Sorry.
some larvae in there, so that'll do. We'll use that. Can't see queen, there's pollen. Alright, so we'll put that one in. That'll be 4 frames. So will that be enough for the... This one?
No, this one.
Oh, the one you've got.
So I've got 2 with metal and 2 with fishing line left.
Okay. So. Excuse me, girls, I'm going to take all this off you. You really don't need it there.
So you want me to put one of these empty ones in here?
Sorry? On the outside, yeah. Oh, queen might be on the outside, they're all sitting on the front.
That's not good.
Well, whoops, now I bumped your box.
Okay, I've got 2 frames in here.
Yeah. I don't keep tripping over stuff, do I?
That's got fishing lines.
Which one?
The 2 I've got left with foundation, I've got fishing.
Okay,
well,
have a look in a second.
But I've got the other frames out of the new hive, which I got the guide board on.
Really old funky frame. Hey Dad,
or Mum, you grab some more of the
for me. So you got one without?
Yeah, I've got these ones, I've all got none, because they're for the other hive. So they're all fresh frames.
Snake.
this top wire. They could be just landing on there because it's in front of the hive.
Yeah.
Yeah, because they've got pollen and stuff on them. Alright, smoke all these girls so I can try and put these pops back on. Coming in hot. Sorry, girls. Okay. We've got to come towards the front a bit more, I think. Potato hang in the back a little. Potato hang.
Probably that front corner.
Yeah, it's overhanging here too. Whoops.
That's going to be pretty good.
That's a bit super wonky.
Yeah, no, but it's square-ish. Square is a
good. You've still got mostly hive here. But yeah, you've got, even though we've put the five into that one,
most of the girls are in.
Most of them are in here, plus you've got the medium, which has got these in it.
Yeah.
They're going to have to produce their own queen over there, that's all. Now, if we get them up there, if we get this back over there. Sorry, girls. We're going down. Sorry, she's on my hand.
Woohoo!
That was close. Oh, didn't squish any at the front. Okay, hang on. Sorry, little one. Whoop, no, I just made it worse. No, she's gone. Kind of. smoking or non-smoking. Yes, hello girls. I'm going to pick yous all back up and put yous back in your beehive. Is that okay? Did you get the inner cover for the other one?
Yeah. It's over there. Because you might want to put that one back together now. Okay, smoking's just there.
Yep.
The bit for the other hive just here.
Hey, little one.
Has this got enough frames in it?
How many's it got in there? Count them.
Two, four, no, six.
No, can you already see that?
Okay, I need more.
You need two more? Let me guess, they've all got no foundation.
No, they haven't. I've only got one with foundation. That's a wonky one.
Yeah, wonky.
Wonky.
That'll do. Put this one on the outside. How many you got? Go in there. No, because you only get 9 frames in a 10 frame box.
That's right.
That looks way too much space. I'll be totally honest with you, that looks like way too much space.
They're moving more on the way here.
Oh, that's a bit better. Now we'll push it back this way a little bit. That looks a bit neater.
A bit better?
Yeah. It's just a lot of propolis on the edges of the frames.
Oh, okay.
Well, so we're stopping them from moving. Oh, they're getting rid of that drone that fell out. They're just taking it away. They're pulling it out. They're taking it out of the hive. Dragging it down. Oh, smoky.
Oh, I'll throw the lid on this one if you want to throw the lid on the
other. Hang on a sec. Get my camera over here. Cause. So we got 5 frames in the new hive with capped brood and uncapped brood and very young larvae. And so there's obviously empty frames on the outside. I might just zoom out a little. Okay, so this is the start of the new flow hive, and that's a 10 frame. Now we go back to our 8 frame box. Now we've got 8 frames in there that have got brood and honey in the ideal or medium super. Bottom super has only 3 frames. But because there's brood in the medium as well as in there, that'll be fine. Then we put the empty frames in with the wax. And then in the top, obviously, we have the flow hive, which is got some honey and nectar in it. So they're doing well. So it shouldn't take too long for these two to take off. This one over here is pretty calm. I got a feeling we might have moved your queen in here.
No.
And they're a bit grumpy over there. So you'll end up with getting a new queen in one of them. And if we inspect them and we end up finding one's queenless, we're just going to move the brood in from the other one. So it won't be a problem. So they'll get used to their new home and hopefully it'll be all good. Easiest walk-away split ever. Any of these over there? I'll hop back over here and set this back up on my stand and keep recording.
Put your wonky hive back together.
God, this is really wonky.
pleasure working on that new one. It's much easier to put back together and pull apart.
Zoom out. There we go. Okay.
I'll get that bit of wax stuff at the bottom there. There's a couple of bits of dead drone in it, but that's all right. We just sacrifice that little bit. I might take that little bit of comb off the top of this before we put the lid on. The girls seem to be enjoying themselves there, but take this bit of comb off. We want to be able to get the lid on. Yes, I'm stealing your little bits of comb. Thing in my hand.
Can you,
Can I?
Do you waxify this cover for me?
What's wrong with it? Oh, wow, look at that. That's propolis.
Yeah.
It's a lot harder than wax. Yeah. Okay. They're pretty calm, these ones. We might have ended up with the queen in here. Or maybe not. So we'll put your lid on, put you girls into the shade. Groovy. Hey, you forgot your wing nut then.
Yeah, I've got to put all the
brass work on. All
the brass work on.
Yeah.
So
this goes this way, so. Goes
in the back.
And
we now have broken one.
There we go.
Happy are
these.
Hey?
Well,
you
gotta
bring your tiller in
the side here. If anything goes wrong. Like I said, if anything goes wrong, you just move brood from one to the other.
Oh yeah, no, I don't think we're going to have a problem at the end of the day, like.
Oh, is that thing just sitting there? I see you haven't put that on.
No, right. I haven't put the brasswork into
it. No, that's okay. All right, well, those ones you can take and do what you like with your honey.
They've got,
hopefully no bees on them.
No, they've got wire in them.
Yeah, that's all right. You can still cut it out. Just cut around the wire.
Cool. So I've got two little frames.
Spare.
Spare.
And then when you cut all that out, you can always put them back in at a later date if you need to.
Yeah, well, I might, because we've got these, so I might just actually glue these into the frames, seeing if I've got the time there.
Yep.
Gonna be a mad rush.
So what's this thing here?
That's my spare. That's my spare. One of my spare boxes.
Yep.
That's what I had in case we had the do a split or whatever, so I had a spare box at the end of the confusing.
Move that out of the way.
Is that going inside?
Hey?
Yeah, it goes back in the cab.
Oh, yeah, we'll go left to the sea. You're right. I'm just making sure there's no bees on it.
There's one on the outside of that white box.
Cool. If you're videoing me again, you never get good footage, you know that?
Oh, of course not.
Cool. Well, hopefully they'll be happy in their two new homes. They'll probably fly out and go back in that one, but some of them will stay. And because there's nurse bees in this one, they'll stay, and if the queen's in here, well, they'll definitely stay. If they haven't got a queen, well, they'll make a queen, and if they don't, well, this one will make a queen, because we've got eggs and we've got larvae in both. So either way, we'll end up with a queen in both. And it's only if they get upset and stroppy, and we won't know that for a few months, then we'll have to deal with new queens and stuff, but they should be good. So, there you go.
Thank you for that.
New beehive.
Didn't get time to pull the plug.
bloody ant thingies on there.
Oh, you can put them on after. We can, you can still get them on. Well, it's all right. You can do that. We can just put a jack underneath the front, hold it up, and wheel them out. Happy now?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Thank you for that.
I didn't put the strap back on your hive, but
that does, oh, I haven't had it on there for ages.
Oh, right. Okay. Yeah, you're right. It's photos. Alright.
That's awesome.
Let's see if we can upload this video. Woohoo!
These girls will choose the recommend out the new hive to go forage.
Okay. Well, that or they'll come back to the other hive. But it doesn't matter because eventually the ones that are in here will hatch and they'll come out and they'll come back here because this is their home. Yeah. They'll do orientation flights.
Yeah.
That won't be for the next day or so. Yeah. And what you do lose, well, you're going back eventually anyway. Plus, you got 5 frames in this one.
Oh, yeah. Well, at the end of the day,
so you've got plenty.
They got empty frames, and they're hopefully not going to swarm.
Well, the other thing is that one there, you've got the ideal's got like nearly 6 frames were brood in it. And you've only got 3 in the bottom. But because you've got the ideal, well, this one doesn't.
And it was weird because when we went through that last time, there was no brood in the ideal at all. It was all in the base.
Yeah.
So they've actually been moving things around. It's good.
Well, the good thing is it doesn't matter if you queen which one your queen's in, because the other one's going to make a queen. So the next time you go through it,
yeah,
which could be in a couple of weeks,
yeah,
I'd let them settle.
Yeah, no, I'll be a couple of weeks before I go.
And then we could fix the legs up and all that, and then you can once you've done all that, we can have a look in there, and you never know, this could be chock-a-block and you need to put the next box on.
Yeah, well, I've got to do one more coat on that and then sand all the bits.
Yeah, but that's okay. You've got time.
I've got time now. So
you've got a couple of weeks, so yeah. All right, if you want to move that one away, and we're all done. Awesome. Another wonderful day in the bee yard. Oh,